Hi guys, welcome to Big Daddy's Kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how to make a classic Italian pasta sauce with a couple of Big Daddy modifications. Now I usually make a lot of this and use it later for a lot of pasta dishes like lasagnas, spaghetti with meatballs, baked penne, seafood marinaras, all sorts of good stuff. This is what you need. Some extra virgin olive oil, not EVOO. It's really not that difficult to say, so please have some respect for extra virgin olive oil and call it what it is. We need about a half a cup of this. 2 cloves of garlic. About 4 tablespoons of tomato paste. Some fresh basil. 2 teaspoons of oregano. About 1 tablespoon of salt. About 2 kgs or 5 pounds of tomatoes. Now you can use canned tomatoes for these ones, but I saw these today at the local market and it was kind of like love at first sight. Are they gorgeous? Almost too good to eat. Almost. And for the Big Daddy touch, I got 1 tablespoon of brown sugar, light brown sugar, and I got 1 teaspoon of chili flakes. Now this is just gonna give it an extra kick. And what the brown sugar is going to do, since I'm using fresh tomatoes, it's going to cut the acidity of the tomatoes. If you're using canned tomatoes, you don't have to use brown sugar, but I quite like that sweetness that it brings out in the tomatoes. Okay, put your pot on medium heat and add in about 1/2 cup of olive oil. Don't be shy, this is good stuff, be generous with it. About that much. And right away, put your crushed garlic in there. All of that good garlic. Spread it out. Make sure it doesn't get burnt and brown. It has a tendency to become really bitter if it gets burnt, so you don't want it to get burnt. As soon as you hear that sizzle with the olive oil, add in there your tomatoes, like so. Right away you can smell that garlic and it smells really, really, really nice. What you want to do, all the stems that you had from your tomatoes, add those to your sauce. What this does is you'll find out, if you smell it, it smells like a tomato garden, and what this does, it'll add a certain amount of freshness to your sauce that you'll be looking for. So throw those in there. We'll fish them out afterwards. To that, add your oregano, your salt, and your crushed pepper. Give everything a good mix. And cover this up and let it cook for about an hour. Okay guys, about an hour has passed by now and the whole house has a wonderful smell to it. I smell garlic, tomatoes, even a little bit of olive oil. As you can see, most of our tomatoes have cooked and they've kind of mashed up a little bit. And if you noticed, I didn't peel the tomato skins off. If you use your spoon, they tend to peel off like that easily. But a little trick is take a whisk and just mash everything up together a little bit like that. And what you'll see is a lot of the skin will just get attached to that whisk and you can take it off like that. That saves you a load of time. Also take a notice of all the water that has been released from the tomatoes. We don't need to add any water into this. You don't need to add any, you know, fancy wine or anything like that into it. This is just simple, rustic tomato sauce. Tomatoes, garlic, and basil, your simple ingredients, a little bit of olive oil, and that's what it's all about. If you just whisk it a little bit, mash everything together, you'll see that it all comes together. Still, I've still got these in here. I'm going to let them cook a little bit more and release some more aromas. Don't want to throw them away yet. But what I'm going to do is take my tomato paste now and put all of it in there, like so. Also, I'll take my brown sugar and chuck that in there too. And give everything a nice mix. Now I want to say something. A lot of recipes ask for red wine to be added to this sauce. All that does is the sugar from the red wine will take the acidity away from your tomatoes. We don't want to do that today. We're using brown sugar, so there's no need for red wine. Just keep it simple, guys. Give that a good mix and cover that up for another half hour or so. Okay, guys, about half an hour has passed, and as you can see, our sauce is getting the right texture and consistency that we're looking for. At this point, I'm gonna fish out our little stems, give it a good stir, and the sauce is almost done. The only thing remaining is our basil, which I've taken off the stems, and I'm not gonna cut them up. I wanna keep that texture, I wanna keep that look of basil. I don't wanna lose any flavors to the cutting board, or I don't wanna make the leaves go brown when I cut them up. So just take them off the stems, just no normal leaves right there. Put your basil in there. Your heat is off. It's not going to cook really any longer. Whatever heat you have in the tomato sauce is what's going to bring out all the flavors from your basil leaves. And give that a good stir like that. And there is your pasta sauce. I'm just going to let this cool for about half an hour or so before I take it any further than that. And let those basil flavors get seeped into our tomato sauce. Okay, guys, our sauce has been resting for about half an hour. As you can see, we got beautiful texture, we got beautiful color. The reason I didn't cook the basil any longer and I turned the heat off is that you can see that green color as a contrast to your red colors. It smells wonderful. I just want to give it a taste. That is really, really good pasta sauce. So you can use this right away. You can put it in the fridge for about a week or so, or you can put it in the freezer for about 3 months. So that's it, guys. That's the Big Daddy pasta sauce. And remember, never trust a skinny chef.